This is an important report. The report of Wasting Our Waterways, Toxic Industrial Pollution, and Restoring the Promise of the Clean Water Act is a critical step, again, in trying to restore much of what I think in the last several years has been a retrograde movement in Pennsylvania and allowing our streams to further deteriorate. While some statistics can be shown to show that actually the streams have improved in certain areas, other areas are again threatened in a way in which I think this becomes critically important. The report provides us with key information about the impact of industrial pollution and what it has done to our nation's waterways and our public streams in Pennsylvania as well. As a member of the House Environmental Resources and Energy Committee, I am ever concerned about the future stability of our natural heritage and the health of our environment. And since being sworn into office, I have been calling for more empirical data about the health of our waterways and the impact industry has had on our natural resources, and especially our streams. In October of 2013, committee staff submitted a right to know request on my behalf to the Pennsylvania Department of Environmental Protection for an assessment of the bromide concentrations in the Allegheny River. My staff, I requested this information as a follow-up to a Clean Water Action lawsuit filed against Waste Treatment Corporation for possible discharging of high levels of salt or bromides and heavy metals and radioactive compounds into the Allegheny estuary. Unfortunately, my right to know request was answered with little more than lip service and denials. While I realize that Governor Corbett is famous for being friendly with industry, we as a state cannot lose our right and sight of the importance of ensuring that our natural resources and our public health are protected from harm by many of the corporations in the state. Our future and the health of our environment depend on the safeguards being properly enforced by both the state and the federal government. Another issue, again, that I think at another time, possibly Adam, we can come back to with Penn Environment, is to deal with, as he mentioned before, the prohibition for natural gas operators of using open pits, waste pits, for storage water, which threaten our streams as well through potential leaks. Many spills, leaks, and other problems have led to contamination of our water, soil, and air. And it's these particular errors that take place, and I think all of us realize that errors will happen, mistakes happen in the process. We need to be prepared and need to have the resources to make sure that any time that this happens through industry throughout the state, by accidental occurrence, that we have the resources to be able to clean this up and to be able to make it so that our streams remain pure and able to be enjoyed by the populace of Pennsylvania and people throughout the nation. I was joined just 2 days ago by two constituents out of my district who came to my office and talked about their experience in visiting all of the state parks in Pennsylvania throughout all the 67 counties. And I was fascinated. One of the constituents is 9 years old. And as he sat on the sofa in my office and he told me about all the wonderful adventures he's had, especially over the last 3 years of the ones that he's taken full enjoyment of in the early age of 6 to 9. And one of those particular occurrences was up in Ricketts Glen, which I think many of you know is one of the most wonderful parks really we have in Pennsylvania. And he told me about the experience as a six-year-old of landing a four-pound trout in one of the streams in Ricketts Glen, and beyond being amazed, because I've never caught anything over a pound and a half, and you know, in terms of the streams there. I would love to see if all of us could see the expression on his face, because what he said after that, and it says, not only was it exciting to catch it, but it instilled in him the belief that everybody should have that experience as a child in Pennsylvania. And his fear is, again, because of fracking expansion in our state forests and state land, state park lands, that may not happen for every child in Pennsylvania. And that's something that resonates with me. It was very deeply felt by him, and I think it's something that we all need to be concerned with, that we make sure that our streams remain as pristine as when William Penn got off the boat here in Pennsylvania back in the 17th century. So we want to make sure that that's available for everyone. So again, I want to thank Penn Environment and for their actions on this report, which I think go a long way to pointing out the overall dangers throughout the nation and here in Pennsylvania specifically.